Hello everyone, I am from CSE department Lalpur Khalsa College of Engineering presenting this video for PPS. Course code is BTPS 10118 and today the topic of discussion is file handling in C programming. In the previous lectures we have discussed about the various modes of files like read, write and append mode. Afterwards, we have discussed about how we can open a file, how we can close a file. Also, we have seen various demonstrations, how we can read and write in a text file. So, we have demonstrated how we can open a text file in read, write or append mode and then how we can close it. So in today's lecture, I'm going to demonstrate you how we can open and close a binary mode file. So we are creating a binary file. We are writing and reading in the same file and then we'll be closing the file. So when a numerical data is to be transferred to disk from RAM, the data occupies more space. Memory space on the disk. So here thus we use the text mode. We don't use the text mode as it is inefficient for last storage. So that is why we make use of using the binary files here, and there will be various operations that we can be perform over the binary file. So here we are going to discuss about a program to open a file in read write operation in a binary mode file. So here we have to read and write. New information in the binary file. So firstly we'll be generating a new file, or let's say if the file is already existing, so we can rewrite in the file and then we can read the same information that is updated in the file. So let's see how we can do this. So here firstly we are attempting to open a binary file with extension .dat. DAT. So the name of my file is B file. So here the file is B file dot dat, and I'm going to open this file in a write mode. So here we are using the write mode for binary file, that is WB. So the file can be opened with the same similar syntax that we use for text files. So here we are using the file pointer, which is pointing to the file structure, and we are using a variable C to hold the data, and then the syntax for opening the file is same. First we have to mention the file name and then the write mode. So since we are dealing with the binary files now, that is why I have used the extension .dat, and the mode here is WB, that is to write a binary file. And similar to the text file, if compiler is unable to open the file, then it simply returns us null. And if the file pointer is null, then we'll simply print a message, cannot open a file, and the program will terminate here. Now, though we have opened the file, and now we want to simply write the information into our file. So this is how I can write the information. I am using the same procedure as we are done with text files. So here we'll be writing till dot operator dot is encountered. Till then the compiler will read the information and insert it into the file. So I'm using the getche here. So C variable will hold the input it data and put it into the file pointer, and I'm using here the function fputc. So when I need to stop the entering of data, so when I want to terminate the data writing, I simply have to press the dot button and I will exit from this loop. So after writing into my file, I have to close my file. Now I want to read the same data, same information that I have stored into the file. So here I am reading my binary file bfile.dat, under which I have stored some information, and I am again opening the same file with rb, that is the read mode for binary. So I am now opening the file in read mode to read the binary file, and then the content will be displayed by using the loop while till the pointer, file pointer, reaches to the end of file. It will display the whole data and give us the output. So let's see the output now. I'm going to run my program. So here is my output. Firstly, I have to write some data to my binary file. Let's say I have written here welcome to my world. So this has been written into my file, and by pressing dot I will be terminating my program. So here I have pressed the button dot. Now I want to see what have entered into the file. So again I will be opening the output screen. Here you can see I have written the data welcome to my world, and the contents that I have read from the file are welcome to my world. So my binary file has created, it will be opened, and then I have updated the information and all the data is displayed here. So this is how we can open the binary file, or we can create a new file and open it in a write read mode, and similarly we can use the other mode of operations to a binary file, and in the similar way we can append some new data in along with my existing file by using the AB mode. Also we can use R plus B mode for read and write both operation, W plus B, that is for write and read mode, and A plus B mode, that is for append the data into the binary file. So this is how different modes can be used to modify or to create a binary file here. Next we are having few more file input output functions, and here is the one, that is fprintf. This function is used for writing characters, strings, integer, floats, etc. to the file. So by using the fprint function, we use it to write characters in various format that we have already used. The other function we can use is here fprintf. So by using this function, we can write characters as well as strings as well as integer or float, any data type, into our file. So this function is also termed as formatted function, and it contains one or more parameter, that is a file pointer which points to the open file. So here the syntax of fprintf is given. Firstly we have to mention the file pointer, then the type of the variable we are going to input, or the formatted string, that is if a integer value will be inputted, then we'll be using here a percentage d, and if it is a float value, then percentage f, and so on. So here we'll be giving the variable name. So this is how the fprintf function can be used. So looking into the example here, firstly we are having three variables. One is of integer type with value 12, one is float type with value 2.356, and the other one is having of character type having value as s. So here we are first creating a file pointer, opening out.txt file. This is a text file with name out, and we are opening it into the write mode. So here we are writing the characters. First is of integer type I, so that is why we are using percentage d over here. The other one is of float type x, so that is why we are using percentage f, and ch is of character type, and that is why we are using percentage c over here. So we have written all the three values as assigned, and they will be inserted into the file. So this is how we can use the fprintf function. So here is another example in which we are going to read and write into the file by using the fprintf and fscanf functions. So here we are created two file pointers. One is out file and the other one is in file, and we are having a variable of integer type, that is b equals to 5, and f is again integer type variable, and we are having a float variable, that is a. So the value of a is here 13.72. c is again a float variable with the value 6.68, and e is a float variable again, and g is also a float variable. So firstly we are going to write the data into our existing file. So we are using the file pointer, that is out file, and this is the opening procedure. Firstly we have to mention the file name, and we are opening it in the write mode because we want to write into the file. So here by using the fprintf function we will be able to write the variables into the file. So firstly we have given the file pointer name, that is out file, then the value formatted strings, that is float, integer, and again a float variable, and here we are using the value for a, b, and c. Here a is float type, c is again of float type, that is why we have mentioned here percentage f and percentage f, and b is of float type, integer type, and that is why we have mentioned here percentage d. And then we have to close our file. So this is how we are closing the file, by using the file pointer out file. And we are done with the writing into the file operations. So now we want to read the content from the file now. So here we are again opening the file. This is our test data. So we are opening the same file in the write mode again by using the in file pointer. In file is again a file pointer here. So we are using the in file pointer to open the test data file in a read mode. Now we want to read the content from the file, so that is why we are using here fscanf function and giving here file pointer, and the values we want to read will be, the variable names will be provided along with the addresses. So here we are referring to the address of e, since we want to read the value of e. And here we are referring to the address of f, which is of integer type, and that is why we have provided here percentage d, and we want to read the value of g, that is why we are referring to the address of g here, which is a float value. So we are providing here percentage f string format. So this is how we can read and write into the file. So here we are simply displaying the values of a, b, c, and e, f, g. So whatsoever data is been written or read from the file, they all will be displayed over the output screen. So this is how we can make use of the functions fprintf and fscanf. Next we are having is ftel function. This is a file function again. It returns the current position of the file pointer. It returns the pointer from the beginning of file. The current position of file is detected with this function. So this is the syntax of ftel function. Offset is a variable which is equals to ftel. This is the file pointer we will be mentioning here. So it will return us a current position for a particular input or output into a file. So let's see into the example over here. Firstly, we are having a file pointer with the name stream. So here we are opening a text file in write mode. Then by using the fprintf function, we'll be writing into the file. So we are using here file pointer and writing this text, that is, this is a test. So this text will be written into the file. So now we are simply displaying a message, the file pointer is at byte percentage LD. So here we are using a long integer, so it can return any of the current position. So this is how we are using ftel function to return the current position into a file so that we can input or get the output from the file. So here we are using the stream, that is the f file, that is the file pointer here, and we are ultimately closing the file. So here in this program, it will basically tell us the current position in bytes. Next, we are having a file function fseek. So fseek can be used to access the part of the file rather than the whole file. So we can ask or request for a particular part of a file. So the file pointer can be moved to any position in a file. The positions file pointer on the stream here, it basically returns as the particular portion of a file. So this function will set the file position indicator for the stream pointed to by stream, or you can say it seeks a specified place within a file and modify it. So in the syntax of seek function, we'll be using three arguments. One is the beginning of the file, that is the file pointer. The other one we are having is the offset. Offset may be positive or negative. So the offset being a variable of type long. So the third one will be the current position of the file. So here in this we are using here seek test. Seek set, that is the beginning of the file. Seek current, that is will return us the current position. And seeks from end, here end of file will be returned. So let's see, let's have a look to the example here. We are firstly trying to open a file, myfile.txt in write mode. So here we are writing here a text by using the fputs function. Hello world will be written in the file, and here f is the file pointer. Here we are using the seek function fseek. So here in fseek function, here we are providing the file pointer. Then 6 byte means the file pointer is repositioned in the forward direction by 6 bytes. So it will be reset to the 6 to the position in forward direction by 6 bytes. So it will be reset over here, and there will be again writing a text that is India by using the fputs function, and this is the file pointer again. And after writing into the file, we are closing the file here. So here we have selected a particular portion of the file, rewrite it, and then close the file. So this is how we can use the seek function, that is fseek function, to modify our already existing file. So this is all for today's lecture. Thank you very much.